Indy Mogul.
Hey Indy Moglers, Griffin here, and I hope you had a great Christmas or a wonderful Hanukkah so far. Let me know in the comments if you received any exciting new video equipment. I, for one, got a brand new piece of gear, a present I built for myself, and I'd like to show you how to build it too. We're only 8 days away from the Iowa caucuses, and it's clear that 2012 will be a very political year. With all the speeches and campaign commercials we'll see before the November election, perhaps the most important piece of video equipment in 2012 will be the teleprompter. A teleprompter lets on-screen talent look directly into the camera lens while reading lines. Great for politicians, newscasters, video bloggers, but they can cost thousands of dollars. So I'll show you how I built my own DIY version for just $35. The basic principle is a monitor laying flat and an angled piece of glass which reflects the image. The camera shoots through the glass so the talent can look right at the lens while reading. Here's what you'll need. Some sort of flat monitor. I already own a 10-inch LCD that I bought from a guy in Hong Kong, but this build could easily be modified for another monitor, an iPad, a Kindle, or a tablet PC. I bought an 8x10 solid wood picture frame, a small sheet of birch plywood, a pine 1x2, small hinges, a dowel rod, 4 shelf hooks, a long 1/4-inch screw, a 1/4-inch wood insert, some flannel, and an elastic band. I also used my jigsaw, miter saw, drill, hammer, screwdrivers, some screws and nails, wood glue, gaff tape, and sewing needle and thread. You've got to be safe. Only use tools you're familiar with, and get parental supervision if you're under 18. And please, wear safety goggles when using power tools. First, I removed the glass and cardboard from the picture frame and cut a piece of plywood roughly the same size as the frame. My jigsaw can make all the cuts in this build, but I used my miter saw to get cleaner cuts. I attached hinges to the frame, drilling pilot holes first to keep the wood from cracking. Then I attached the plywood. This will be the base for the monitor. To hold the glass at a 45-degree angle, I drilled 5/16-inch holes halfway through the frame and at a 45-degree angle in the plywood, then cut dowel rods to fit. To hold the monitor in place, I drilled 4 small holes to fit shelf hooks, and then I cut the whole base a little shorter to clean things up. I've seen a lot of DIY teleprompter designs where the monitor is separate from the camera, but I wanted to include a camera mount so I could pan and tilt or go handheld without readjusting the monitor. So for the camera mounting arm, I stacked and glued 3 pieces of 1x2 and reinforced it with some screws. I cut 2 pieces of plywood, a small one for the camera base, and a longer one to connect the camera mount to the monitor base. I also included a thin strip of aluminum I had as reinforcement, in case the wood decides to crack one day. To finish the camera mount, I drilled a 5/16-inch hole and added the long 1/4-inch screw. For a tripod mount on the bottom of the whole unit, I drilled another 5/16-inch hole and installed a 1/4-inch wood insert. The teleprompter is almost complete, but it needs a shade to keep light from hitting the camera side of the glass. That thick cardboard that came with the frame, I cut out 2 triangles and nailed them to the sides of the frame. Next, I used flannel to cover the top of the box, attaching it with gaff tape. I also put my limited sewing skills to the test to make an elastic sleeve to hug the camera lens. After putting glass back in the frame, the teleprompter is complete. But does it work? To get words on the screen, my LCD monitor can either play images off a flash drive, or I can connect it to my computer. I'm using free teleprompter software called Prompt Lite, which works on Mac and PC. As you can see, words appear on one side, but are completely invisible to the camera. In fact, the glass barely affects the image at all. I also picked up a free sample of transparent mirror from my local glass shop. The reflection is a lot sharper, but it's too dark to film through. You can buy expensive teleprompter glass called beam splitter glass, which is highly reflective on one side and highly transparent on the other, but I'm satisfied with how well regular glass works. But here's what I want to know. When I'm reading from the prompter, can you see my eyes moving? And does it make a difference how close I am to the camera? And does it even look better than cue cards or mounting my monitor right below the camera? I don't know. So let's do some side-by-side tests. You guys watch while I read lyrics from the most watched music video of 2011. 7 a.m., waking up in the morning, gotta be fresh, gotta go downstairs, gotta have my bowl, gotta have cereal. Seeing everything, the time is going, ticking on and on, everybody's rushing. Gotta get down to the bus stop, gotta catch my bus, I see my friends. Kicking in the front seat, sitting in the back seat, gotta make my mind up, which seat can I take? It's Friday, gotta get down on Friday. Everybody's looking forward to the weekend. Friday, we, so excited. Partying, yeah. Fun, looking forward to the weekend. Now we know it's possible to build a cheap, portable DIY teleprompter that works really well. For only $35, you can convert an LCD monitor or iPad. It doesn't require expensive special glass, and it looks much better than cue cards. Thanks for watching. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions, and be sure to watch Movie Quest this Wednesday. On Monday, I'll introduce you to Indy Mogul's next awesome director.